This season, there were so many hookups, you couldn't even keep up. I mean, episode one, you see like three or four hookups happen.
We see in the first episode and we saw in the trailer that there's quite a few hookups this season, but
a lot.
What about on your end?
Yeah, I think that, I mean, right off the rip, you see so many hookups. I for sure build really good connection with Esther. I think Esther was one of my favorite people in that house. She's just so fun and so funny to be around. And I think that you guys are gonna be able to see that personality. So we hit it off. I don't know what they're gonna show, but I definitely vibe with her. But I mean, this season, there were so many hookups, you couldn't even keep up. I mean, episode one, you see like three or four hookups happen, which you're gonna see all those relationships play out, which are so messy. Yeah, there was a lot of hooking up. I mean, we were in one of the sickest houses we've ever been in. There's the hottest cast that has ever been in the house, and we all came off of quarantine. So people were hooking up left and right. I mean, I lost count like day five of who was hooking up with who. So everybody was just like touching everybody and just like hooking up in every corner.
I mean, literally every single person is attractive. It's unreal. Yeah, like, yeah, I'm like, yeah. Where did they find these people?
Yeah, Cassie killed it.
Truly. So when you guys got outside and got chained up to the bricks, how long were you out there until they arrived?
Hours. I mean, we were, this is the sickest part that they don't show. TJ comes out with literally like cases of snakes, spiders, like a whole bunch of shit, and they start throwing it everywhere. So I don't know why they cut that out, but we were screaming legit. Like I don't know why they cut that out, but it was like giant snakes like just crawling all around us, like on our shoulders, crawling up the bricks. So it was terrifying. Yeah, we were out there, I would say like 3 to 4 hours, even longer than that. It felt like forever. And then as they came approaching, just the anxiety and the buildup and the hype, which you guys saw, but yeah, we were out there for a while.
It looked like, so something that surprised me, because I feel like you said, every single person on this season, new or returning, it's like a beast. I feel like there's no weak links. But it surprised me the way that we saw that people were like, where's Corey? Where's Nelson? Like, people didn't go to CT first. People didn't go to some of the, do you feel like that's like a shift overall, that these, like, even the newer vets like you are becoming that like main class?
I think that with obviously respect to all the OGs, because I think with doing the show time after time, you build nothing but more and more respect for all the people that have kind of paved the way and built the show to what it is, like CT and Johnny and all those people. But I think this newer class, we're just like hungrier. We have something to prove, especially with this group. There was not many winners, so we all have the heart and the drive to finally, for me, make a final. Corey Wharton to get that first win. So I think that, you know, the rookies definitely see that in past seasons and see the fight that we have. And I, if anything, I'm so excited and grateful and thankful that I am part of like this new wave of like vets that are just like willing to do whatever it takes to win and get to that final. So, yeah, it's just really cool to be part of it.